My name is Lotte Bjerre Knudsen, and I work for the pharmaceutical company Novo Nordisk, which is located in Copenhagen, Denmark. The purpose of the study that is presented here in this article was to study the mechanism of action for liraglutide in weight loss. Liraglutide is an analog of human GLP-1 that has been engineered to have a long half-life so that it is suitable for once daily injection to patients in a simple pen device. And liraglutide has already been approved for the treatment of type 2 diabetes, but is now in clinical development for the treatment of obesity. We know that liraglutide lowers body weight in humans by increasing feelings of satiety and decreasing feelings of hunger, leading to a lowered energy intake. So the study questions that we asked ourselves here is, does liraglutide enter the brain following peripheral administration, and which GLP-1 receptor expressing regions in the brain are the target for liraglutide, and how are the classical appetite regulating signals affected by liraglutide treatment? When looking at the classical appetite-related signals, we used a rat model where we compared liraglutide not only to a normal control group, but also to a group of animals that had been restricted in their food intake so that they weighed the same as the ones on liraglutide. And what we showed was that liraglutide was able to increase the levels of CART, did not have any effect on POMC levels, and liraglutide lowered or kept low the levels of AgRP and NPY compared to the weight-matched and hungry control animals. When looking at liraglutide access to the brain, we used a novel technique called single-plane illumination microscopy, which can be used to visualize peptide access to whole brain structures. We used a fluorescently labeled version of liraglutide, dosed it to animals, and took out the brain and put them in a scanner, and then started the scanner. So what the scanner does is it collects individual images of sections of the brain. And after the scanning is complete, those can be reconstructed to an entire brain. And what is shown here is a video that can also be found in the supplementing section for the article at the journal website, where, and if you imagine you sort of peel off the surface of the brain and look into it, you can see that liraglutide is clearly measurable in discrete areas of the brain. When analyzing those structures in more detail, we see that many of those are the circumventricular organs that are known to express GLP-1 receptors, but there are also areas located in the hypothalamus. For example, the arcuate nucleus and the paraventricular nucleus are also directly targeted by liraglutide. When we looked specifically at what happened in the arcuate nucleus, we did co-staining with CART, as shown here. And when we looked at the fluorescent signal from liraglutide, we saw that liraglutide was present in the same neurons that had a strong co-staining for CART. We also, in the article, propose a neuronal model for how liraglutide works in the arcuate. It is shown here, and what we propose is that liraglutide directly targets POMC neurons, which are known to have a GLP-1 receptor. But since we know that liraglutide also has important effects to inhibit NPY AgRP neurons, but those do not have a GLP-1 receptor, then we have proposed a model where this is mediated by a GABA interneuron and that may also have a GLP-1 receptor, or it is effectuated via the POMC neurons. So in summary, when liraglutide is injected peripherally, we clearly detect it not only in the circumventricular organs, but also in discrete sites in the hypothalamus. And we see that liraglutide directly targets the GLP-1 receptor on POMC neurons. And those neurons also respond electrophysiologically to locally applied GLP-1. So the mode of action for liraglutide in body weight regulation seems consistent with a direct activation of POMC CART neurons in the arc, mediating an increase in satiety, and an indirect GABA interneuron-dependent inhibition of NPY AgRP neurons resulting in a decrease in hunger, and both the increase in satiety and the decrease in hunger have been confirmed in a clinical study. Thank you for watching this little video describing how liraglutide works in regulation of body weight, and I hope that you will enjoy reading the article.